A very good morning to all. We now begin with Honeysuckle, English for class 6. Lesson 2, How the Dog Found Himself a New Master. So before we read, you may know that the dog and the wolf are closely related. You may also know something about how over the centuries, human beings have domesticated and tamed wild animals. Here is a story about how the dog became a tame animal. So when we talk about wild animals and we see a wolf or a jackal, it is almost similar to a dog. So a dog, we say they are from the wolf family because they look alike. So now, sometimes human beings domesticate and tame certain wild animals. Domesticate and tame means they keep these wild animals as their pets. They train them and they tame them. So here is a story about a dog who is domesticated by man and how the dog himself has found a new master for him. So now let us read and enjoy this story. Dogs were once their own masters and lived the way wolves do, in freedom, until a dog was born who was ill-pleased with the way of life. He was sick and tired of wandering about by himself. So here this paragraph tries to say that the dogs were also the masters of their own. They also lived freely how the other wolves lived. But there was one dog who was tired and not happy with his life. What type of life? Life of wandering from one place to another. Wandering means moving from one place to the other without any aim. So he was sick and tired of this life that he was living. Who was tired? The dog was tired of this life. Looking for food and being frightened of those who were stronger than he. So that dog was sick and tired of moving from one place to the other alone. And he had to search his own food. And he also had to be frightened of the other animals that were stronger than him. Why frightened? So that other animals which were stronger could hunt him and eat him. So he had to be frightened of the other animals. He thought it over and decided the best thing for him to do was to become the servant of one who was stronger than anyone on earth. And he set out to find such a master. So one day this tired dog who was tired wandering from one place to the other for food and had to remain frightened decided for himself, now the best thing for me is that I should become the servant of someone who is the strongest and he can stay with him safely. So he finally decided and he went in search for such a master. So he was searching for a master with whom he could be safe and he would be his servant. He walked and he walked and he met a kinsman of his, a big wolf who was as strong as he was fierce. "Where are you going, dog?" the wolf asked. "I am looking for someone to take up service with. Would you like to be my master, wolf?" "I don't see why not," the wolf said. And this agreed upon. The two of them went on together. The dog set out to find a master for himself. Now, as he was on his way, he found a relative of him, his. A relative means he found a big wolf on the way. A kinsman is a close relative who are similar. So he found the wolf on the way. Now that wolf asked the dog that where was he going. So the dog replied that he was looking for someone to whom he could serve. He wanted to be the servant of that of that animal. So he asked the wolf that would you like me to become your servant? So the wolf was quite happy. He said, why not? You can be my servant. And then both of them set off together. They walked and they walked. And all of a sudden, the wolf lifted his nose, sniffed, darted quickly off the path and into the bushes, and crept deeper into the forest. The dog was much surprised. What's come over you, master? He asked. What has frightened you so? Can't you see? There's a bear out there, and he might eat up both of us, you and me. So now, as both were walking, who both? The big wolf and the dog. So as they were walking, suddenly the wolf lifted his nose and he started smelling. And he got the smell of another animal. That was a big bear. So the wolf, along with the dog, they went deep into the bushes and deeper into the forest and they hid themselves. So dog was surprised that why such a big wolf is frightened of something. So he asked the master that why are you so much frightened? So that wolf told him that can't you see that there is a big bear nearby? Now if the bear sees us, he will hunt us and eat both of us. So the wolf was frightened of the bear. Seeing that the bear was stronger than the wolf, the dog decided to take up service with him. And he left the wolf and asked the bear to be his master. Now, the dog saw that the wolf was afraid of the bear and he hid himself deep into the bushes. So then the dog decided that this wolf is of no use and he has to take up service with the bear. So he asked the bear whether he could become his master and he can be the servant of his and serve him. So he left the wolf and he became the servant and he went for service with the bear. The bear agreed to this readily and said, let us go and find a herd of cows. I'll kill a cow and then we can both eat our fill. So now the bear was very happy that and he agreed, okay, you can be my servant. Now who left? Now both of them left. Who both? The bear and the dog. Now as they were walking, what the bear said, now let us search for a herd of cows. Then I will go and hunt one cow and we then both can sit and eat the cow. So now what happened? They walked on and soon saw a herd of cows. But just as they went about to come up to it, they were stopped by a terrible noise. The cows were mooing loudly and running in a panic in all directions. So now what happened? Suddenly, when the bear was just about to go and hunt for a cow, what happened? That the herd of cows were running and they were making that mooing noise and they were moving in all directions and they both stopped. Who both? The bear and the dog. The bear looked out from behind a tree and then he too ran hastily deep into the forest. Now the bear waited. Why? Because he saw that the herd of cow were running from one place to another in all directions. So when he hid himself behind the tree and he was watching at those cows, that why were they reacting in that way? So when he saw, he too went deep into one of the bushes, right deep into the forest and hid himself. So here in the picture you can see the cows are running in all the directions from here to there and hiding. That bear and that dog They are watching why the cows are reacting in that way. They have hidden themselves behind a tree.
"Now, why did I have to come here?" said he to the dog. "It's the lion who rules the forest in these parts."
"Lion? Who is he?"
"Don't you know? He's the strongest beast on earth."
"Well then, I say goodbye to you, bear. I want a master who is stronger than anyone on earth."
Now, the bear told the dog that why we had to hide because of the lion. The lion rules in those parts of the forest, so even he had to hide from the lion. So the dog asked him, "Lion, who is this lion?" So the bear told the dog that this lion is the strongest animal on earth. So then the dog said, "Then it is, if he is the strongest, then I have to say goodbye to you, because even you are afraid of the lion." And he wanted who? He wanted the strongest animal on the earth to whom he could serve, so that he could be saved. So he told goodbye to the bear and he thought of joining with the lion. And off the dog went to ask the lion to be his master. The lion agreed to it. And then the dog stayed with him and served him for a long, long time. It was a good life, and he had nothing to complain of, for there was no stronger beast in the forest than the lion, and no one dared touch the dog or offend him in any way. So now the dog left the bear and he went to the lion to ask him whether he can become his master, and he becomes his servant. And the lion agreed that why not, he can be his servant. So now he started staying with the lion. Now for a very, very long time, the dog served this lion as a servant. And the dog was also enjoying with him. Why? Because there was no other stronger animal than the lion in the forest. So the dog had no complaint against the lion. And he was enjoying his life with the lion, as no other animal tried to ever come and touch or hunt the dog, because he always used to stay with the lion. So he was feeling he was the safest with the lion.
But one day the two of them were walking side by side along the path that ran amid bare cliffs, when all of a sudden the lion stopped. One day, both the lion and the dog, they were walking along a side of a cliff in an open area between two cliffs. And suddenly there the lion too stopped. He gave a great roar and struck the ground angrily with his paw with such force that a hole formed there. Then he began to back away very quietly. Now, that day too, the lion stopped there and he started scratching the ground angrily, and slowly, slowly, he started moving backward.
"What is it, master? Is anything wrong?" asked the dog, surprised.
"I smell a man coming this way," the lion said. "We'd better run for it or we'll be in trouble." So the dog was surprised that why is the lion reacting in that way. So when he asked the lion that why was he doing it, reacting in that way, the lion said that he could smell a man coming close. So he told the dog that it would be better that we run away from this place. Otherwise, they both would be in trouble.
"Oh, well, then I say goodbye to you, lion. I want a master who is stronger than anyone on earth."
So now, As the lion reacted in this way, the dog understood that even the lion is frightened of someone. So as soon as the dog came to know that the lion is frightened and afraid of a man, so on that spot he said bye-bye to the lion and he told him that I don't need you as my master, because he wanted someone who is the strongest on the earth.
And off the dog went to join the man, and he stayed with him and served him faithfully. This happened long, long ago, but to this day, the dog is man's most loyal servant and knows no other master. So then the dog left the lion and he joined the man, and he made man as his master. So this story happened many, many years ago, but till now we see that a dog is serving very faithfully to man, and in turn the man also takes care of the dog, and in the other contrary, the dog serves the man and guides him and serves him very, very faithfully. And the dog till now, he has never found for any other master but except a man. I hope you have understood this story. Now there is a passage, a paragraph which will give us more information about a dog. So now let us read and understand that passage. The dog family. The dog family is one of the 11 families that make up the carnivores, a large group of intelligent, flesh-eating, backed-boned animals. In this group are such varied animals as bears, pandas, raccoons, cats, hyenas, and even seal. The dog or canine family has many wild species like wolves, fox, coyotes, jackals, and wild dogs. So to understand this paragraph, there are 11 families of carnivorous animals. So among these 11, one is this dog family. So these dog families also are flesh eating. They hunt other animals. They have a well backbone. And there are different types of carnivore animals. Now these dog family, which is one of the carnivores, even in the dog family, there are different types of dogs and different types of relative animals, such as jackals, they look like dogs, foxes, wolves, another type of wild dogs which are found in the jungle. So they all are from the dog family.
The dog is the only domesticated member of the canine family, though now and then someone tames a wolf, fox, or coyote as a pet. All members of the dog family are descendants of a wolf-like animal which lived about 15 million years ago. From this distant ancestor, the true dogs gradually developed. But nobody knows the exact ancestor of the modern domestic dog. Among the canine family animals, only this dog is mostly kept as a pet or domesticated. Now, canine, as you all know, children, they are the front teeth of the animals which they use for hunting. So, even dogs have canines which are very sharp. And these dogs are now domesticated and kept as pets. But there are certain people who keep a wolf and a fox and a coyote also as a pet. But here in India, we have rarely seen. So these also are animals which they keep as pets. Now these dogs are the descendants, means they are the offspring of a wolf-like animal kingdom. So they are all from the wolf family. And they are the descendants, they are the offspring of a wolf family. Several wild dogs look and behave like domestic dogs. The dingo, or wild dog of Australia, is one of these. It is possible that the dingo was a tame dog brought to Australia long ago, which then ran wild. Dogs were the first animals tamed by humans, perhaps 20,000 years ago. Tamed dogs were brought from Asia to the New World 5,000 or more years ago. Dogs were first used for hunting.
There are several wild dogs also that can be domesticated. Now, for example, this is dingo from Australia. It is a wild dog, but it is tamed and it is domesticated. Now, dogs were the first animals that were domesticated or tamed by human beings, but perhaps 20,000 years ago. And these dogs were also used for hunting. So, students, this is the end of the chapter. And the question answers of both how the dog found a master for himself and a few exercises of this dog family will be shared with you in part 2. So thank you.